My name is Allison Margolin. I'm a criminal defense lawyer. I do all criminal defense, state and federal, from marijuana to murder. I think that the criminalization of drugs is really the criminalization of thought. The drug war represents probably the greatest curb of our innate freedoms that this country has perpetrated on anybody. Criminalizing drugs is almost just like criminalizing intent. So obviously we all have to take responsibility for ourselves.
The path of the criminal defense attorney, both someone with as heart and cares about their clients and does what they can to help those in need.
There is at least 100,000 people in jail or prison for marijuana alone. I'm pretty confident that the federal prisons are filled mostly with drug offenders. A lot of times, when someone's charged with a drug crime, the police will come in, freeze their bank accounts, take their cars, and they have 30 days upon receipt of notice of this to do anything about it. And a lot of times people don't get the notice. People are in jail, they don't realize what's going on. And this is how like a lot of our police agencies are funded. The issues with marijuana, that people can grow it themselves. They don't need to depend on like the consumer economy. I think that's part of what the threat is of marijuana specifically. There's no such thing as a therapeutic index for marijuana, meaning there's no level at which it will kill you from overdose.
This is my attorney, Allison Margolin.
We're at the San Fernando court.
I was charged with cultivation and possession of marijuana. I'm a caregiver for at least 9 other patients, and I'm a patient myself. All of my patients have current up-to-date letters. I have a current up-to-date letter. They investigated and found I had a high electric bill, and then they raided my house and woke me up in the morning. And then now we're here, I've hired an excellent attorney, and we're gonna prove my innocence.
First we filed what's called a demur, which is a motion to dismiss, and we said that actually the district attorney's office has not stated a crime in their complaint because cultivating marijuana in and of itself is not a crime if it is for medical purposes. They don't have any evidence of sales. He wasn't growing more than really an expert would say was appropriate for this many patients, and I think he has a good chance, really.
I'm very pleased with my counsel. I couldn't be happier, and it's helped me sleep well at night after the raid.
Well, if you live in California, I would say get a recommendation from your doctor. A lot of people are afraid because they think that your name goes on a list. And what's interesting about that is actually the state is supposed to give out ID cards, but that hasn't happened yet. So this is really anybody who has that fear should not fear, because right now there is no state ID card. All there is a marijuana recommendation. You get it from your doctor. You know, the government can't just start seizing our medical files.
I'm using these sentencing decisions to try to allow for judges to have more discretion in federal courts so that they can give lower sentences or no sentence to pot offenders.
We feel that the better way to spend our resources is on education and programs of rehabilitation, but incarceration not only defeats the person's own sense of worth, but also deprives the public of the resources that are better spent on dangerous criminals and protecting the public.